Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to Old Times. Ooh, there's a coin under there. Can I get it? I can't reach it. Oh, yeah, I did get it. Okay, since the last episode, I have moved things around a little bit on the map. I'll grab that coin a second. I have bought a few chickens. I have bought 50 chickens, which actually cost me a small fortune, but, you know, there we go. Some things you've just got to do. What's in there? Oh, you can't really see anything in there. So the chickens are here running around. I'm not sure where they lay their eggs yet, but that's something that we will find out. I've taken the burra back to the shop because we couldn't pick up the cultivator, and I've got the hurliman right here with the canola. I've moved the combine there, ready to start into the wheat. So we will get onto the wheat shortly. Remember, today's question is, do you want me to turn plant withering on or off? Today's, I said, this week's question. So do you want me to turn plant withering on or off for the duration of this map? It is your vote. It is your game. And this cultivator here, I don't have a tractor that can even move it. So we will just go straight to our garage and we will sell it from here. So that's 4,700. And I have changed it to euros. Yes, I did. I'm a very good boy. I did sell it. Right, so we'll sell that one for 4,700 euros. Now, if we back up a little bit, we want to go to category mods and then cultivators here. There, right, so I've got this lizard one, which is an old one. That would be from the lizard pack. That's a 55 horsepower cultivator. That's a 2.5 meter working width. This one here is a bearish. I got no clue. I'm not even going to begin to try and pronounce that. It looks like a sort of a homemade cultivator almost. I don't know, it might not be. No, it's a, I don't know, but we got that one as well. That one is 3,950. This one is 3,500. The lizard is obviously the invented machinery category for Farming Simulator. But I'm thinking, actually, I'm going to go for the slightly more expensive one. I want to go for this one rather than this one. I don't know why, because I've never actually tried this one. They're both the same working width, so we'll go with that one, and that can go on to the burra. I'm also going to need a seed drill. So we go to sowing machines, and I've got this seed drill here, which is actually probably, I would estimate, in the style of the 60s and 70s, whereas this one is a much older one. So this one here is from the Classics Pack from the Farming Simulator website. This one here is from the Classics Pack that I got from Mod Hoster, which is the older Classics Pack. I'm torn, because I'd actually like to try both of them. I think we're going to try this one first, and then we'll move to this one. This is a wider machine. So we'll actually need that one when we want to come and do potatoes and stuff. So we'll start with this one. Even though it is slightly cheaper, I still want to go with that one. Now, something else I've been thinking about, and do I... Oh, we've got two of them here. They are very small plows. But what I was wondering is, should I cultivate a plow before I cultivate? Because obviously that's what they used to do. So I'm not going to for now, but that is actually going to be next week's question. Just, you know, I'm going to tell you now what next week's question is going to be. So you can choose to answer it if you want to, but I will be asking you if you think I should just sort of stay in keeping. Do you think I should plow all the fields before I cultivate them? I'm thinking that I should. I think that would fit in really well with the sort of the flavour of the map. But anyway, that's next week's question, not this week, so I won't go on about that anymore. Let's tip this one out. How does this work? Ah, I see. So it doesn't even have a tip. You've actually got to get up there with a shovel and shovel the stuff out after dropping the side down. I have had to do that in real life, and believe me, it's not nearly as easy as that guy just made it look. Okay, it's a lot harder than that. Now what I'm going to do is we're going to start... I did go on a bit while I was in the shop, and I do apologise for that. I've sort of wasted a lot of time there. I do tend to go on sometimes. If you think that I am rabbiting on too much... Sorry, I just wanted to listen to that one turn over a few times before it started. That's brilliant. If you think I am sort of rabbiting on too much, feel free to point it out in some of the episodes. You know, just say, oh, easy there, Frith. You're going on a little bit too much once again. Yeah, I won't be offended, I promise. Now, the wheat is, I'm guessing, going to be a lot more productive than the canola. Obviously, it sells for a lot less. And I don't think these fields have been... You don't get very much straw. I don't think these fields have been fertilised either. Right, I want to turn it on, and then I want to switch over and lift the header. There. I think we're going to buy the bigger combine soon. Not for a minute, because obviously we've now run out of money. Spent it all. That's okay. We will come back to it. So we're going to need to get a baler at some point so that we can bale up this straw and then sell it, because that is actually quite a valuable product, especially years ago. These days, it doesn't tend to, the percentage of value that you get doesn't make that big a difference, but with the smaller farms, straw made quite a difference. So, you know, with the extra little money, every little penny you could get made a huge difference. And this field's quite a bit bigger than the other two. Obviously, I did the two smallest fields that we've got. I want to do a couple of rounds, maybe even three rounds of the field, so that then I can put the hired help going, and then when the hired help is busy working on this field, I can then go and get the cultivator and I can cultivate those two small fields. We will just do standard cultivation and then sowing to start with, and we'll look at changing our ways if you guys all want me to next week, but that will be next week, not this week. Pick that one up. Now, I wasn't picking it up when I was doing the canola, but that's mainly because there's nothing to worry about. When I was actually driving combines for my job, when you were doing canola or oilseed rape, as it's known in this country, you didn't bother picking up the header when you're going around because you ran it quite high anyway. So, very rare that you actually bother just picking the thing up. You just sort of leave it as it was. But when you're doing crops like this, especially when you're leaving a swath, you would always pick the header up on the headlands, or whenever you were turning, even. Right. Yeah, because the last thing you want to do is get loads of straw going in the front, because that can sometimes clog your machine up. Okay, I'm going to finish going round. I'll get a couple of rounds of the field, and then we'll come back to it. I am out of cab at the moment. I've gone nearly twice around the field. I did actually do a couple of extra cuts along the bottom end so that I don't need to go back down there, and a little bit more. There we go. Right, that is one full tank. So let me just switch over. There we go. Bring that one out, and I will run back up here and we will collect this tractor, drive this one back down. And I'm wondering if I should go back and get the second trailer, because I've left that one parked down over there by the side of the road. It might be useful. I don't know, because it is fairly difficult to manoeuvre. But if we bring this one down along here, we can just run along the edge. I don't have a huge amount of money left. I've got €1,695. By the time we finish the harvest, it will be less than that, because I've got the hired help will be taking up some of it. So the problem that I've got is I want to buy a baler. So we might actually take out some loan in order to buy the baler, and then we can bale up this field and collect all the bales. What we'll probably do is we'll probably sell it all. I'm thinking we'll sell all the straw, because that little bit of extra money would be hugely valuable to us. It's going to make a massive difference. What do we get in this tank in the end? I forgot to check how much we get in the tank. I will just hop out. Let's hop into the tractor, and then we can see how much we're getting. I am actually tipping out on the road ever so slightly. That'll be all right. We'll live through that. We'll survive. Can I look into the top and see in the grain? Yes, we can. We can see into the grain tank. It's very slow moving across. What are we down to on the lizzo? It's 22%. 20%. So it is quite slow. Funneling it across, but overall it's not too bad. One trailer full, or one tank full, is nearly a trailer full. So we will get this one back up to the field. Right, 3,700 is one tank. Let's go into here. There we go, and put that one back. I'll start this one up again. Right. We're going to head up to the top, and then we're going to set the hired help going on this one. And once the hired help is going, we will empty this trailer and bring it back so we're ready to collect the next tank full. And then we're going to go and get the cultivator. I might just get the second trailer on here. And we'll see how this tractor copes with pulling two trailers. Could be interesting. Could be a bit of a challenge for it. Who knows? So let me just pick up the header. All I got to do is do an extra cut along the top here, and then I think we can basically leave it to it. I'll go once back and forth, I think. Can't quite fit there. There's a great big lump. We'll have to come over that way. There we go. Put the header down. And now come in round like that. Right. Let the hired help do that a second, just so that we can see it turn on the end. You've got the ditches here at the end. That's something that we've got to be aware of. And the hired help is actually going to have to start just down there so that it goes to the end of the field and then comes back all the way up here. Don't think three is going to be quite enough room for him to turn around, especially because the ditch up that end is a bit tighter. He drove into the hedge there. That wasn't quite so good. So four, I think, is about right with this narrow header. I was just looking in the shop also for the other header and to see what the dimensions of it were. This one is 4.8 metres. Let's turn the hired help off. Just quickly, I'll show you the header on this one. Where is it? There. This one here is 4.8 and that one is 5.3. So you get an extra half a metre of cutting width if we get the bigger combine. And I think you get a bigger tank as well. I didn't actually check that bit. So it might be worth upgrading this combine at some point. Although the other combine does cost 17,000, which is a huge sum of money. Especially on our low-earning farm here that we've got. Now, if I start the combine up... Oops. There. Start the combine up. We'll come down here, and I just want to make sure that I've lined it up just right. There. Now I'll turn the hired help on, and hopefully he'll do the rest. He seems to be. Right, I'm going to let him get on with that, and I'm going to trust that he can. And we are going to go and unload that trailer over there. So let's just jump off the combine and romp through the cornfield over to the tractor. Right, come on then. Let's go and sell now. Remember, I cannot drive on the corn because I will leave wheel marks and I don't want to be doing that. So we'll go and sell this. We'll go and unload this trailer full. And then I'm going to go and get the other trailer and hitch that onto the back and then come back and have two trailers here. So that I don't have to unload quite so often, and then we can go and hitch in the cultivator and get that going in one of the other fields. We'll sort of get several operations underway all at once. Do we have it? Oh, we've got two eggs as well. So we will be able to find out soon where the eggs are hiding. They're somewhere in the yard, as far as I know. Let's tip that out there. It's going the wrong side. Oh, we'll live with that. Right, tip that out there. Now I think we can go this way to get the trailer. That is the fountain so that we can refill the water tank. We've got a gold coin down there. I'll pick that up another time. Don't worry about that just now. The trailer, where did I leave that? Oh, that's all the way down over there. So if we go and grab that one. I'm going to grab that trailer and then I'll take this tractor back over to the field that we're harvesting, which is field 5. And then we will go over and have a look at the new cultivator. Right, here is our burra. We have the seed drill and the cultivator there waiting for us. So if I hitch in this cultivator, turn around a minute, there we go. Right, so I'll hitch in the cultivator and we'll take this one over and we will start cultivating field 9, which is just over the way from us here. There we go. Perfect. Ah, now this one we can pick up. Much better than the last one. Right. Well, then, we will get some bigger tractors later on, because obviously there were bigger tractors that were manufactured prior to 1980. It's just at the moment we will start with these smaller, much older tractors. I am actually really looking forward to next week and finding out what you guys say about the cultivation. I'm not going to do very much cultivating. I'll just do these two fields this week, I think. I'm not going to do any more, because I'm really keen to find out what everybody's going to say. I quite like the idea, actually, of ploughing before we cultivate, sort of keeping with how things used to be done. I realise in the States, things were quite a bit different, and I've been having a bit of a discussion with someone, actually, about using chisel ploughs and mouldboard ploughs weren't really used at all in the States, at least not in the last 50 years. I guess they were in places, just you wouldn't see them very often. whereas in the UK and Europe, it was much more common for everything to be ploughed using a mouldboard plough prior to cultivating. So I am quite keen to see what everybody says, especially considering this is a European map. I hope that that is what you will tell me, and I am kind of regretting that I didn't think of asking this as this week's question. But we can't change that, so I will keep the format. I will keep the format. It'll be one question per week, so we will carry on and cultivate here. So what I'm going to do, I'll keep an eye on the numbers coming up off of that monitor. Oops, skipping outside of the field boundaries there. That's all right. Let's go into in-cab. Not much of a cab. And it is nice, actually, being able to see behind you like this. You've got nice visibility on here. This is so much better visibility than you get in some of the more modern tractors. Having spent some time driving much older machines like this as well, I can vouch that the visibility is wonderful. And on a warm, sunny day, well, not too sunny, because I don't like it to get too baking hot, but say on a warm day that is slightly overcast, there is nothing finer than driving around a field in a tractor like this. When it is baking hot and you've got no shade at all, or when it is hoofing it down with rain, I can assure you that the modern comforts of a cab are really, really appreciated. Right, I'm just going to stop there a second, and we are going to skip off of this tractor, and we're going to run over and have a look at that combine, because we need to unload it. Right, is it 100%? I tell you what, we're not going to get very many tankfuls out of this field, but this is all right. We will just park this one underneath the auger right here. There, and I'll just leave it to it. We can go back to the cultivating now and let this combine carry on. I'll run back over to our cultivator and we'll finish doing the couple rounds around the outside of the field. Something I am quite liking about this whole map is, because it's so small and the fields are small, you don't have lots of travel time in between the different vehicles and stuff. It just makes it all a little bit more convenient for getting around. Now, what I think I'll do, if I drop that one down, I'll do a couple of passes back and forth across this end of the field. So let me just pick up there, spin it round. We will at some point do some chainsawing as well. That is something I am going to do. I'm going to do a little bit of forestry. I'm going to look up some different mods that we might be able to use. Unfortunately, I am going to have to use a chainsaw, which isn't something I'm that keen on in this game, to be honest, especially... the combine's off again. Yeah, I'm especially not keen on having to clean the branches all the way down through. I've never been that fond of it. I don't really like the way that it works. I suppose it's all right. But yeah, so it is something that I will have to do, because as far as I'm aware, there were no automated cutting machines manufactured prior to about 1983. And if someone is aware of any type of automated cutting machine, it was made before then, and we can find a mod for one, that would be absolutely fantastic. Right, that would be brilliant. I will see what I can do to use any mod like that to save me having to do too much chainsaw work. Right, let's drop that one down there. That's probably enough up at this end. If I go and do the same down the other end of the field, we'll then be able to leave the hired help to do the rest. Just pick that one up there. Let's go in cab a second. I'm going to be using in cab quite a bit, but also, again, I use the out of cab purely so that we can sort of admire the machine and see what it's like, and so that I can, you know, sometimes just see what I'm doing. But I like admiring machines. I like looking at the machines. I think they look really good. Even these old ones. I mean, a lot of people are sort of, they go, ooh, wow, with the big new modern machinery. And I don't blame you, because they look very impressive. Some of the modern machines are absolutely fantastic to look at. But again, I really like these old machines as well. Sort of any agricultural machine. I've always enjoyed looking at them and learning about them and so on. And it is just great to be able to watch them working. So I will sort of do a combination of the two. Do point out if I am sort of doing too much of one and not enough of the other. I know that some people prefer in cab and some people prefer out of cab, so you can see this stuff in action. Now, I'm hoping that we've done enough at the top and bottom end of the field that we can set the hired help doing this. So I'm going to come out of cab and just make sure that he doesn't miss anything on this first stripe up across the field, and we'll see how well he turns. But I am out of time, so as soon as he's done this little bit. Now, with the terrain and dirt mod, or terrain and soil mod, something like that, I'm not quite sure. He is going to back into the hedge just a little bit, which is slightly unrealistic. Not quite happy about that, but we'll have to live with it. Yeah, with this mod, you do sometimes get the cultivator bouncing up out of the ground because it moves slightly too fast, and because the mod makes the ground quite bouncy, quite uneven. So we do have to sort of keep an eye out for that. Some cultivators aren't really suitable for using with the mod because they allow the machine to travel too fast for them. That one seems to be okay, he's going all right. So I'll skip off of that tractor and we'll start walking back over here towards the other field. In the meantime, thank you very much for watching this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, then please head down below and give me a like. That would be utterly fantastic. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.